What a week. Donald Trump taking to social media this week to quickly counterattack Jeb Bush's attack ad against him on social media. So Trump and others using the virtually free virtual medium to get their message out and gather support. While no one seems to do it better than the Donald, Steve, is this another reason why we don't need campaign finance laws?
Well, campaign finance laws shouldn't be there anyway, whether you have social media or not. Social media is replacing traditional press releases. People watch social media, they don't read press releases, and Donald recognized that before the others. But even if you didn't have social media, you're still going to have to use field forces, you're still going to have to use polls and other traditional things, newspapers and the like, if you're going to wage a long national campaign. And as for laws, David, they have about the same effect as Kleenex stopping the flow of the Mississippi River. Get rid of them.
I get the point. That's a good visual image. But, Mark, isn't it ironic, Mark, that the candidates with the most amount of money right now, Hillary and Bush, are going down the fastest? It's not helping them.
It's not helping them. Social media isn't helping them.
Well,
and
I don't
social
know.
Media is paid for by big corporations and big special interests.
But it doesn't cost any money.
Social media doesn't cost Trump a dime. We're hiring firms that are putting this stuff out. I mean, it's people. It's not done by a computer.
The fact is
our system is broken.
Okay,
David,
gotcha. But John, the fact is that the money that these candidates are spending on social media is nothing compared to the ads that you have to put on television.
Exactly, and of course they can all pay for this social media, so we can't blame it on one. But the main point here that Steve gets at is that we shouldn't have laws on campaign finance. That violates our right to free speech. And as he also points out, it doesn't keep money from reaching politics. But there's an obvious unintended consequence, precisely because politicians can only get $2,000 from each donation from big names. They're spending lots of times with rich people, whereas if they didn't have those limits, they could spend more time with voters.
That's true. Rich, the fact is that the laws meant to keep big money out of politics haven't worked since McCain-Feingold. That was the law, the big law that was supposed to stop big politics. Look what's happened since then. A lot more money has gone in politics since that law was put into place.
Steve is right. It's unstoppable. People are creative. They'll find ways to get money to their candidates. But I am for transparency. For example, Larry Ellison gave $3 million to Marco Rubio. I think that's fine. But B, I think everybody should know. That's the fact.
So, Carrie, just put the information out there and let the voters decide.
Yeah, I mean, Rich is right. We need to have transparency. But look, in the grand scheme of things, Americans spend more on chewing gum than on running our national system for the most powerful country in the world. Let's put that in perspective. Let's also talk about the fact that Bernie Sanders, Mr. Socialist, benefits from free social media. So he's the one who's whining about the influence of money, but social media makes him relevant against Hillary Clinton, who is a multimillionaire,
right,
despite what she says about being dead
broke.
Well,
Sabrina, what I love is the irony of the richest guy in a race, Donald Trump, who has billions of dollars, spending almost nothing and getting huge amount of traction with those social media ads.
Well, right. I mean, first of all, I think John put all of this, he said it perfectly. I couldn't have said it better. But I think, David, you're right. And there's a lot of people who are going to jump on that and say, see, we don't need money in politics because look what Donald Trump could do. But I couldn't disagree more. For starters, just a bare bones, we have actually no real evidence about the impact that social media is having on get out the vote efforts. There's going to be a lot of studies done, I'm sure, this season. But we don't really know that there's an impact. And it doesn't really matter. If people want to spend their money on TV ads and giving kickbacks to consultants and whatnot, fine, let them do that. But if they want to spend it on social media, they should be allowed to do that
and
too.
And Mark, talk about impact. Look at the lack of impact that McCain-Feingold, a bipartisan measure meant to keep all the big money out of politics. It hasn't worked. We've gone in exactly the opposite direction. Yes, we have.
Laws,
we showed the figures.
The laws have not worked, and we no longer have a democratic system. The 400 richest people.
So we're not voting for people anymore.
50% of the money for the Republican and the Democratic candidates up now on the slate have been given by the 400 richest Americans. So who do you think is going to get the response?
Wait a minute. Hold on a second.
It's the rich person who writes the big checks.
Bernie Sanders, who's a socialist, according to Mark's liking, is getting tremendous traction without using a lot of money by using social media.
Well, that's true. And in terms of people wanting, again, to give contributions, you're going to need, in this, as this campaign progresses, David, social media is not going to cut it alone. You're going to need operatives on the ground
that's
to get
true.
Out the vote. You got to get your message out in various ways to all kinds of people. And so you need the resources to do it. Make it open. And people have always given to politics, going back 200 years. We have had a democracy
it's
that
true,
long.
And works. There are two things against coming up with more laws, campaign
rules.
Finance laws, Kerry. One is that the current laws aren't working, and two, social media is working and it doesn't cost a lot of money.
Yeah, let's talk about Eric Cantor. He is out of office thanks to social media. Let's talk about candidates who have spent millions of dollars. Yeah. Carly Fiorina has spent a ton of money. Meg Whitman, just because you spend money doesn't mean you're going to win.
Quick last word to Sabrina. Go ahead.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more with Kerry. I was actually going to say earlier that I think sometimes the candidates with the most money are the ones who are overhandled and mess things up the most. So
I agree.
Let's see how things, you know.